Welcome to Cisco Center of Excellence at NHCE course Routing and Switching 2. So today's lab we are going to configure Hot Standby Redundancy Protocol, that is HSRP. It is a first hop redundancy protocol. The default gateway limitations are that in case a particular default gateway, that is the exit or entry point of the network, fails, then none of the devices within the network will be able to connect outside the particular network. So it becomes essential to have a redundant router or the default gateway. So if the default gateway cannot be reached, then the local device or the end device will not be able to send packets outside that particular network. So to have the redundancy, the basic idea is to use a virtual router and have an actual active and a standby router. So we have Hot Standby Router Protocol, which is a Cisco proprietary protocol, also called as Hot Standby Redundancy Protocol. So in this particular protocol, there is an active router and a standby router, and there is a virtual router which is not physically present. The active router will take the identity of this virtual router and act as a gateway. The standby router will take the identity of this virtual router and act as the default gateway only when the active router fails. So they periodically keep exchanging, the active and standby routers keeps exchanging hello packets. So whenever standby router stop receiving hello messages from the active router, then it declares that the active router has failed and it needs to take the role of the virtual router and become the default gateway. There is another virtual router redundancy protocol, which is a non-Cisco proprietary protocol. However, as per the syllabus, we have to configure HSRP, because it is the Cisco Center of Excellence. So HSRP, as I told you, there will be a virtual router with a virtual IP. This virtual IP needs to be configured as default gateway on the PCs. Right? We will not be configuring default gateway as the IP address of router 1 10.2 or the IP address of router 2 10.3. Instead, we have to configure the virtual IP, that is 10.1, as default gateway on all the PCs or the end devices. Because we say that R1 being the active router will take the identity of the virtual router and become the default gateway. In case this active router fails, then the standby router R2 will take the identity of the virtual router and act as the default gateway. So the routers, we can group them together into groups which will be acting as active or standby router for that particular group or the network. So the group numbers that you can assign for HSRP configuration will range from 0 to 255. So we'll be looking at this topology where we have two routers and a router 0. We have the switches over here. We have the PCs and another PC over here. So we will be looking at this configuration, and in this we have to assign the IP addresses, which has been already covered as part of routing switching 1. So configure router 1 as active router for HSRP. Group number is given to us is 1 with IP address 192.168.10.1. So this is the IP address of the virtual router, and we have to configure priority 150 on router 1. Now, why this priority 150? By default, the priorities on all on routers is 100 for the HSRP. So if both the routers have same priorities, then how to decide which particular router will be the active router and which will be the standby? Whichever router has the highest configured IP address on the gigabit interface will become the active router, and the other one with the lower IP address will become the standby router. But in case we want to modify and we want that router 1 or router 2, whichever router we want to make it as a particular active router, for that router we can increase the priority. So here we are configuring router 1 as the active router and increasing its priority to 150. Then we have to configure router 2 as standby router for HSRP with group number 1, and the virtual IP is 10.1. And we also need to configure re-election. So let us take an example that this is our main power supply. The active router is the main power supply of our home. And this router 2, which is the standby router, is the generator backup, right? In case the main supply fails, then the generator automatically starts and takes over the control. But when the power comes back, then this generator should give the control back to the main supply. So in this case, what we need to do to give the control back from the standby to the active router, we need to do a re-election process. Re-election should happen to decide which is going to be the active router. Standby router should not continue to be the virtual router, should not continue to act as the default gateway when the main active router comes up again. So re-election should happen, for which we need to do preempt command. So let us look at the configuration. We'll go to the topology in the packet tracer. So here we have to make router 1 as the active router. So already the IP address configuration has been discussed in routing switching 1 course. So we have already assigned the IP addresses. We will go here and enable configure T. And on int g0/0, because that is the interface, if you see, int g0/0 is the interface connecting to the PCs. So on int g0/0, I have to say that standby, the command syntax is standby, and the group number, so the group number given to us is 1, IP 192.168, given to us is 192.168.10.1. So we will use that. And then we are going to change the priority also. Standby 1, priority is 150. Why we want the priority to be increased? Because we want that the priority should be more, so that this router is the active router. If I do not change the priority, default priority is there, then whichever router has the higher IP address on the gigabit interface will become the active router. Also, we want the re-election to happen, so we will use standby 1 preempt command. Re-election, we want that in case router 1 fails and standby router 2 is taking the control, then when router 1 is fixed and comes up again, then the control should come back to router 1. Otherwise, router 2 will continue to act as the default gateway even though router 1 has been fixed. Now we will go to router 2, and again we will go to the interface mode. In the global configuration mode, we will go to the interface mode gigabit 0/0, because that is the interface that is connected to the PC, and we are going to say standby 1. Please remember, the group number has to be same on both the routers if we want to make them as the group of the HSRP, right? Same network. So standby 1, IP is 192.168.10.1. And we need not do anything else on this. We will close it. Now, we will go to the PCs and we'll just check what is the IP address configured. So this IP address we have given is 192.168.10.10 with the subnet mask 255.255.255.0 and the default gateway is 10.1. See, we have given the default gateway as the virtual IP. We have not given the IP address of router 0, that is 10.2. Neither we have given the IP address of router 2, that is 10.3. Okay. Similarly, on PC1 also, same thing we have to do. We have to give the same values here. The IP address is 10.20 and the default gateway is that of the virtual router. Now, we will just check whether we are able to connect to the PC. We'll just fast forward it. The initial packets may fail, so we will try once again and it says successful, right? We can also try pinging from PC1. Initial packet may fail, we will try once again, it is successful, right? So we can go to PC2. I'll just check what is the IP address of PC2. 192.168.20.10. So from PC0, in the command prompt, we can write trace root 192.168.20.10. We'll check it once again. Yes, it is 20.10. So we can see the next hop which goes is 192.168.2.1. Right? So, or we'll do it again. So it is 10.2. 192.168.10.2. Okay, so the first hop that it goes is 192.168.10.2. So router 1 is configured, if you see, router 1 gigabit interface is configured with 192.168.10.2. That means when the packet is leaving the network for PC2, it is going out of this network, then it is going via router 1. Similarly, on PC1 also you can check, go to command prompt, trace root 192.168.20.10. So again, it is going via 10.2, not via 10.3. It is not going via 10.3. On router 2, if you see the gigabit interface, if you want to see, we can control Z, come in the enable mode, show running. If you see the interface int G0/0, the IP address is 10.3. So it is not going via 10.3, instead it is going via 10.2, right? That is through R1, because R1 is acting as the default gateway, because it has taken the identity of virtual router, because it is the active router. We have configured it as active router. Now let us say that I manually shut down that due to some problem, this particular int G0/0 link goes down. So if this link goes down, then will PC0 be able to connect to the PC2? Yes, it is still able to connect to PC2. From PC1 also, we are able to connect to PC2. Then when this has failed, who is able to take care of it? Let us go to command prompt and see. It is 10.3. That is, the standby router has become active and is allowing PC0 to connect to PC2. Similarly, on PC1 also, if we do it again, we can see it is for 10.3. So next hop is 10.3. So the default gateway is router 2. That indicates this router 2, which was the standby, has taken the identity of the virtual router and has become the gateway. Now, if we have done preempt command, and when this link will come up again, if I do no shutdown, the control will come back to this particular router 1. Right? The control will again come back to router 1. Let us see whether we can still ping. The first packet may fail. We will try once again. And it says successful. And let us see again. Now, who has the control? The control has come back to 10.2. But if we wouldn't have done this command preempt, standby preempt command, if we wouldn't have done, then the control wouldn't have come back to router 1. Router 2 would have continued to become the virtual router and act as the default gateway, even though router 1 would have come up. Right? So this is how we configure HSRP. So these are the commands. And to verify this particular configuration, you can go and on any of the router, control Z, in the enable mode, you can write show standby. If you do show standby, you can see the group number. So the group number on both the active and standby router should be same. The state is active, that means it is up. The virtual IP is 10.1, which should be the default gateway on the PCs. The hello time, that is the time interval at which they should interchange the hello packets, should be 3 seconds and it should wait for 10 seconds before it should declare as down, right? So if it has not heard the hello packets for it will wait for another till 10 seconds. If still it doesn't hear any hello packet, then it will be declared as, the other router will be declared as unreachable. Preemption is enabled, that is re-election will happen. Active router here is the local router, that is the router 1 itself is the active router. And the standby router is the router with IP address 10.3. The priority 100 has been changed to priority 150. So the configured priority is 150. The default priority was 100. However, the configured priority is 150, which has been changed from 100 to 150. So, and this has been done on gigabit 0x0. This is how we verify the output. And we had seen using the traceroute command also, how do we verify the output. So, for any doubts you can or queries, you can mail me at er.divyasharma@gmail.com. Thank you.